Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Matt Bailey, who is the founder and CEO of GameOn Entertainment. Matt, a very warm welcome to you. Thanks very much for dialing in from Miami today. I'm going to start by asking you a bit about what it is the company does.
Thanks, Tom. It's good to be here. At GameOn, we're a B2B technology company, and we're making it easy for brands and their fans to get involved in Web3 through games. So we're building things like NFT-powered prediction games and fantasy games for customers like sports teams and leagues around the world, completely from a B2B standpoint.
Understood. So what kind of games are these?
So typically there are games that are dependent on the content that we're working with. So we're not building console games or RPG games or anything like that. We're building things like prediction games, trivia games, fantasy sports games. For example, we've worked with Gaming Society and the WNBA to do a predictor game around the WNBA. Right now we've just launched a March Madness bracket for Dick's Sporting Goods, which is a big retailer here in North America. We're working with a karate league to launch NFTs of the fighters, playable digital fighters that you can then use in a fantasy game that would be dependent on the actual live results. So they're the types of games we're building that we think can be a real catalyst for Web3 and get mainstream adopting Web3 as well.
So Matt, are all the revenues coming from the folks that you're partnering with?
Exactly, yes. So we generate revenue in a few different ways. The first is a setup fee. That's a one-time setup fee that can be anywhere from $20,000 up to $100,000. Then there's a license fee. Once the product is live, the partner or the customer pays us every single month that that product remains live. And often partners are live with us for several years, not just a month or two. And then there's revenue share. If we are selling anything like digital collectibles or tickets or merchandise or whatever it is, we often take a cut of revenue share as well. Sometimes that can be upward of 50% or more. So they're the three different ways that we generate revenue, or all one completely 100% a B2B business model.
Okay, so how did you first identify that there was an opportunity in all this?
So at first, we just took a deep dive into games. We're games people first and foremost, completely on the Web2 side, not on Web3 side when we started the company a few years ago. And we just saw a way to engage an audience more than what former generations have been. So for example, you and I might sit on a couch and watch a full game of soccer or NFL. It might take 3 hours and we're completely fine with that. Millennials and Gen Z are not fine with that. They don't want to sit on the couch and watch sports passively. They don't want to own the sport. They want to consume it in a way where they actually have an influence on the outcome, and they want to play it as well. So millennials and Gen Z are an audience that sports teams and leagues and TV networks and every stakeholder in sports and entertainment are really struggling to capture. And we identified games as a way to achieve engaging that audience, but then Web3 is also another layer where we can really provide ownership and rewards to that audience in a way that they care about. So that's the opportunity we've identified and how we've kind of evolved that over the last couple of years with new technologies.
So it leads me very naturally into my next question, Matt, which is how has the business been performing?
So the business is doing well. We went public about 2 years ago. At that time, we were very much pre-revenue. We generated minimal, about $10,000. Last year, once we report those numbers, there's a pretty big uptick. We've almost nudged seven figures in 2022. And then this year, we expect to generate $3 million or more, and we're on track to do that. We've already booked more revenue this year than we generated last year. So we're confident that we're on the upswing here. We've made a very conscious decision to focus on fundamentals. We've optimized resources and almost halved resources, especially as we finished building the product that we have. And now we're just out there selling, bringing on more revenue. We announced last year, I think in October, we were even, and then in December, we were cash flow positive. So we expect 2023 to not only generate $3 million or more, but we expect that to be very profitable as well. That's been our goal and objective in a market like we're experiencing today. Fundamentals are not only important to survive, but to then thrive and come out the other end better than ever. So that's what we've been focused on.
Well, Matt, I think that's a great note to leave it on. So we're going to wrap it up there. But thank you very much for your time today and best of luck for this year.
No worries. Thanks, Tom.